Welcome into Chase Field in downtown Phoenix. Major League Baseball on tap, the Atlanta Braves and the Arizona Diamondbacks. First pitch coming your way next. All right, first pitch coming up. And on the hill today, Slade Ciccone. What should we keep an eye on here?
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
Here's Jared Kelnick.
Leading off tonight for Atlanta, the center fielder, Jared Kelnick.
The 1-1. And downstairs.
2-2 to count.
Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. Gurriel handles the chance, and there's one down. Here's Brian Snitker's lineup for the Braves. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience, Singy.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These guys have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
One down, base is empty. Ripped to third. Sends it to first. And Albies is retired.
Batting third, the designated hitter, Marcell.
Two outs, base is empty. Marcell Ozuna next up for the Braves. Swings through that one.
One ball, two strikes.
And misses inside. That one ripped left field. Gurriel going back on this one. Pulls it in on the warning track. Middle of the first. No score after a half inning. Back here with my pal Siggy. And today's starter, Max Fried. What should we keep an eye on here?
Power pitcher. He's going to speed you up with the fastball velocity, and out of his hand will explode the breaking ball. Very difficult for hitters to keep that front side closed and hit the ball the other way because they know if they're not ready to pull the trigger, the fastball will beat that.
We go to the bottom of the first, and stepping in is the speedy Jake McCarthy. And a pitch. And that one almost hit him.
Straightened him up a little bit.
Got it by him for the K.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner when with two strikes, you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
Fried, not a big strikeout guy, but still very effective as far as starting pitchers go. One of those guys that involves the defense and really gets them involved in the action. Three, two. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Payoff pitch. And he walked him. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing a walk. Very gritty.
Man at first. Next to hit for Arizona. Ketel Marte. Right through there for a strike.
He moves the ball around all the quadrants of the strike zone and will add and subtract velocity. And because of that, he gets the weak contact. It's all about missing the barrel of the bat.
The 1-2. That one almost got him. It seems like this type of guy is kind of a dying breed nowadays.
Well, exactly. When teams are looking for high velocity, high strikeout rates, a guy like this doesn't necessarily do that. So in order to really appreciate how good he is, you have to see him, because if you're just looking at a stat sheet, you might overlook him.
Kicks and fires. Runner on the go. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. At the belt and fires. Got him swinging. Couldn't catch up to the heater. And now it's Christian Walker. And it's fouled away. First inning, and already up to 23 pitches. Two outs. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. The pitch. In the air, left side. Duvall hauls it in to end the inning. One left for Arizona, scoreless after one. Second inning set to go. Leading off, Matt Olson. And the right-hander deals. And a foul ball. And that one a little below the knees, and it's 3-2. Gets a piece and stays alive. And there's ball four.
I don't think you really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
Here's Austin Riley. One and two now. And another ball. Nobody out. Runner at first. Missed with a changeup. And it's a full count.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Swings. Threw it in. That's a strikeout.
Well, that right there is just a pitcher's pitch. Tailing away from the hitter, low away with some good action at the end. You know, even if he gets the bat to that ball, it's probably just a weak ground ball to the opposite side. Tell you what, that's a tremendous two-strike pitch.
Adam Duvall at the plate. Off the mark there. 2-1.
2 balls, 1 strike.
Man at first, one away. To third, might be two. There's one.
He's out.
And that's two. So they go quietly there. We go to the bottom of inning number two. We're tied, nothing, nothing. Bottom of the second. Here's Gurriel.
The left fielder, Lourdes. Gurriel.
And that just misses. Hit hard, should be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. And he's there with a leadoff double.
You got to get on your horse and get to that ball and get it back in, because he's going to come barreling around first and put some pressure on you. If you bobble it or you don't get there in a hurry, it's going to make you look silly and end up on second base.
Blaze Alexander getting ready to hit. Man at second. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. The throw in, not in time. He's safe as a run scores.
Always feels good when you come through and get your team on the board first. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the runs where you gotta make them pay.
Randall Grichuk now. The pitch. And a curve misses outside. Runner at first with no outs here. Swing and a miss. Ugly swing right there.
Well, when those hitters count, sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
The next offering misses, and it's 3-2. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. He's got it. Runner tagging from first. Laureano hustles to get it in, and the lead runner holds on at second base.
Batting it, the third baseman, Kevin Newman.
The batter now, Kevin Newman. Here it comes. Just missed. One out and a runner at second. Ripped on a line to center. Makes the grab, and there's two away.
Batting done. The catcher. Okay. Herrera.
Here's the catcher to hit, Jose Herrera. Man on second, two down. To the right side, a sliding stop. Takes it himself, and he got him. Nicely done at first for the out. But the RBI single pushes across a run. It's now a 1-0 ball game. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Top half of the third inning. So here's Murphy now.
Sean Murphy.
The wind of the pitch. And that one fouled off. Righty to the plate. And
two
another
balls,
ball.
Two strikes.
Wouldn't chase that time. And that one ripped into right. Fair ball.
That play looks routine defensively, but with all of the little nooks, it can get real tricky down in the corner. Kept it to a long single. Nice defensive play.
Here's Orlando Arcia. And that one missing low. Tying run is at first. We're here in the top half of inning number three. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two. To short could be two. Alexander quickly to second for one. To Walker, and that's two.
Well, almost any time you roll over and send a two ball to short at this level, you can pretty much count on a double play. Middle infielders are just so reliable. And they work on these plays all the time, so it almost becomes like second nature.
Here's Ramon Laureano. A wide to kick the pitch.
Two balls, one strike.
Ball, and there's a ball.
Three balls, one strike.
And that one is lifted in the air. Gurriel handles the chance. And Laureano is retired. And that is that. Back here in the desert, set for the bottom of the third. Here's the Diamondbacks leadoff hitter, Jake McCarthy.
McCarthy.
Left-hand hitter waits. Fly ball center field on his way in. Got it. Really had to move for that grab. And there's one down.
The right fielder, number seven.
This is Corbin Carroll.
Corbin Carroll was an easy choice for Rookie of the Year in 2023. Voters made him the unanimous choice after he put together a consistent season that took a lot of drama away from the announcement. The world of baseball knew he was going to win it.
Hit in the air, left field. Duvall makes the grab, and there's two gone.
The batter, number four, second baseman.
An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte. Well, Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. The next pitch misses, and the count's even at two. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. Two down, nobody on.
Three.
And down on strikes he goes. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Diamondbacks down quickly, but they're on top 1-0. Back here at Chase Field, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Jared Kelner.
Let's go, D-backs!
That clips a corner.
It's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. He usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
And the righty deals. Ground ball right side. Walker takes it himself. One up, one down.
The batter number one. Second baseman. Ozzie Albies.
Ozzie Albies up to the plate. Righty delivers. Little chopper rolls foul. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Now
here's Marcelo Zuna. The pitch. That one inside. And a count 2-1. Kicks and deals. Not close with that one. 3-1.
Here's an opportunity to do some damage and perhaps unlock this offense. 3-1 count. Be ready to turn on a fastball.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And now the count is full. And another power hitter lurking in the on-deck circle. And swing for a strikeout. Slider got him for strike three.
It's a good breaking ball there, just off the corner where you can't really do much damage, but it's close enough where you've got to protect him. He just couldn't find a way to fight it off.
And now Matt Olson up to hit. Two outs. And another ball. A base hit. Lead runner touches second, headed for third. And now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. And man, I'll tell you, a line drive like that into the gap just feels so good. It's feedback that you had everything on time and in control from start to finish with your swing.
Two gone with runners at the corners. Austin Riley next up for the Braves. The 1-1. On the ground, down the line, and it's foul. Two on, two outs. That one not close, and that's ball two. Hits and misses, it's a strikeout.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the jam.
Bottom four. And here's the first baseman, Christian Walker.
The first baseman, Christian Walker.
The pitch. Hammers that one deep left field and forget it. That should put a jolt into this home crowd. It's 2-0.
That's exactly what this crowd wanted to see in this spot. He blasted that pitch. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Here's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. The wind of the pitch.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
The 1-2. And another ball. Swing, and this one's bounced on the ground. Albies tosses to first. One out in the bottom of the fourth.
The batter number nine. Shortstop. Blaze.
Alexander.
Blaze Alexander stands in now for the Diamondbacks. One down, base is empty. That one the other way. Base hit.
The batter, number 15, designated hitter.
Runner on at first with one gone. So next is the designated hitter. There goes the runner. Pitch is high. Throw to second, and he's out.
Well, you can get away a little bit with not being so accurate when you've got such a great arm and you get rid of it quickly, and that's what happened right there. He made up for the lack of accuracy with excellent velocity. Nice job with the catch and throw right there.
The lefty fires. Swing and a miss. Now 3-2.
Count this ball.
Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Pulled the string on the changeup. D-backs get one on the solo jack. And it's 2-0. All set for the start of the inning. So now to the plate for Atlanta, Adam Duvall. And a pitch. Wouldn't chase that time. Activity in the bullpen. Kevin Ginkel appears to be getting loose. Mantiply getting cranked up as well. A wind and a pitch. Lifted in the air right center field. Carroll snags it, one away.
Now
here's Sean Murphy.
Sean Murphy.
The Braves trailing by two, and we're at the top of the fifth. That just misses all three. Inside ball four.
Perfect.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
The shortstop takes the ball. Next one misses. Three balls and a strike.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
Smash to center, way back, and you can forget it. Home run. And this game is tied. It's 2-2.
That's a game changer right there. A big time swing, and we're all tied up. Breaking ball on the inside part of the plate requires a hitter to stay really square with his mechanics. If you fly open with the front shoulder, there's no way you keep that ball fair. An outstanding job mechanically. He deserves that home run.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Slade Ciccone won't go any further tonight. And as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. So out of the pen for the Diamondbacks, number 30.
Still pretty early in the ball game, so this bullpen has some work ahead of them. Best case scenario might be if he can come in here and get several quick outs, kind of bridge the gap that starter left for him.
Base is empty, one away. Ramon Laureano next up for the Braves. Here's a 1-1. And that one sliced foul. One out, base is empty. In the air, right field. Carroll sizes this one up. They got it for out number two.
Now batting the center fielder.
Back to the leadoff spot in the Braves lineup. Jared Kelner next up for the Braves. Two outs, base is empty. And another ball.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
Sliced hard but foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Outside, and that is ball four.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
This one popped up middle of the infield. Alexander should have this one and puts the squeeze on that one. And that is that. Braves pick up two on the long ball. 2-2 game. Major League Baseball is on the show. And we're back.
Leading
here's the third baseman, Kevin Newman.
The third baseman, Kevin Newman.
On its way to the corner, Laureano sprinting after it. Nice grab on the run. And there's one away.
Now batting, catcher, Jose.
Now up next for Arizona, Jose Herrera. All tied up. Last half of inning number five. The 1-1 is fouled off. One down, base is empty. Out to short. Arcia tosses to first, and there are two outs.
Now batting, center fielder, Jake McCarthy.
Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Jake McCarthy. And the pitch.
Hey.
Just off the inside corner, and it's 2-2. And another ball. Swing and a miss, struck him out. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down. 1-2-3. Nothing doing for Arizona. And this game is still tied. And welcome back to the ballpark. All right, we go to the top half of inning number 6. Now it's the DH, Marcell Ozuna. Swing and a miss. Looked off balance that time.
Talk about tying a guy up. That was ugly.
That one inside, and the count's full. Movement in the bullpen. Kevin Ginkel preparing to come on if needed. Mantiply warming up as well. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Swing and a ball hammered left field. Drops for a hit. He couldn't run it down. Throws to second. And he'll pull into second safely.
That ball was drilled 106 off the bat. And that's the kind of feedback that tells you you're right where you want to be with your swing mechanics. A chance now to take the lead. And at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
Head run on base, stepping in the long ball threat, Matt Olson. Left-hand batter waits.
2-1.
Check swing, no appeal. And that's ball two. Man at second. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. Right-handed reliever. That ball is foul, and the pressure is building. Go-ahead run at second, and we're at the top half of the sixth. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout, and there's one away.
That's about as nasty of a splitter as you'll come across, especially in terms of movement. I mean, that thing tumbles out of his hand and just drops off the table at the last moment. If he keeps it down, it's just so tough to put wood on.
So up next, Austin Riley. Swings through that one out in front that time.
One ball, two strikes.
The 1-2. Good job to fight that one off. And a pitch. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Runner at second here. One gone. And he dodges that fastball. And he deals. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Here comes a pitch. And now it's filled up. Adam Duvall in the on-deck circle. Three, two now. And that one finds its way through into third now. So runners at the corners and one out.
Oh, just a nice job coming through in a pretty high leverage spot right there. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team to bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball go deep.
Two on, one out. Next to hit, Adam Duvall. And a pitch. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Close, but call the ball. 3-2 now.
Home plate umpires trying to tighten things up a little bit.
Sean Murphy to bat next. Two on, one out. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Lays out. Oh, it's off his glove. Runner from third in to score. 3-2, they take the lead.
Sean Murphy.
Now it's the Atlanta catcher, Sean Murphy. The pitch. Got him swinging.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Hitters become defensive, and all of a sudden that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
Now at the plate, Orlando Arcia. High fly ball lifted in the air right field. Brings it in for the third out. Two men left stranded, but they do push across one. 2-3-4 due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Braves 3 and the Diamondbacks 2. Back here in the desert, bottom of the sixth. Now the number 2 hitter, Corbin Carroll. The 2-1. This one high in the air to left center. He's got it. And there's one down.
Up next to the diamond. The second baseman. Cattell.
Here's Cattell Marte.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
The Diamondbacks trailing by a run here in the bottom of the sixth. And a swing and a miss. Movement in the Atlanta bullpen. Jesse Chavez, the veteran right-hander, appears to be loosening up. Lee also throwing. One down, base is empty. That one in the dirt, and it's 2-2. Into center and a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
He was all over that
now,
one. Other than ripping one into the gap or blasting one over the wall, there aren't a whole lot of hits that are more satisfying than a nice line drive in the center field. So that definitely felt good.
Man at first with one gone. Christian Walker stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Step off throw to first. And he's back in on a dive. One run game. One out. One on. That's off the mark. 2-1. And now the lefty swings through that.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
And another ball.
On this count, runner not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, though.
Lourdes Gurriel Jr. on deck for Arizona. 3-2 down. On the ground right side. 4-6. Three. It's a double play. And that'll do it for the inning.
Pitcher made the pitch, and his players made the play behind him. Nice job. 4-6-3. Inning ending double play.
Kevin Ginkle takes over on the mound.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Well, one run game. Now it's going to be Ramon Laureano. Kicks and fires. Bounced up the middle, and that chance handled. Fires over to first, and they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh.
The center fielder, number 24.
And now the center fielder, Jared Kelner. One down, base is empty. A little out front there as he swings through it.
One ball, two strikes.
And a swing and a miss. And to Elena.
With that kind of velocity and elevated fastball, even if it's still in the strike zone, can be tough for hitters to get on top of.
Here is Ozzie Albies up to hit. And now the count, 1-2 after the swing and a miss. Two down, nobody on. Here in the top half of inning number 7. Got him looking, and he didn't like the call. Down in order go the Braves, but they still lead it 3-2. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the 7th, Jesse Chavez.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
And it's Lourdes Gurriel Jr.
No left field.
Looking to get the tying run on base. That one out to right. Brings it in. And a quick out number 1.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Holding on to a 1-run lead here at the bottom of the 7th. Strike 2.
One ball, two strikes.
And that's down and away.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with 2 strikes out of the zone.
The 2-2 on the way. He fouls it off. We'll do it again. The pitch. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Good battle here. About to be the 8th pitch of the at-bat. High grounder into the outfield for a knock. So he battled through a long at bat and earned himself a hit. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the battle.
One down, runner at first. And now it's going to be Randall Grichuk. Runner on the move, pitch in for a strike. Throw to second, tag out. out at second.
Well, I really didn't expect him to try to steal second base because he had a very standard lead at best. If you're going to try to get there safely, you've got to get more on that lead. You've got to get a better jump. That was the difference between being safe and out.
Ground ball, Austin Riley. Throws across the diamond. Third out, and that ends the frame. Back here at Chase Field, ready to begin the eighth. And now the DH, Marcell Ozuna. And the right-hander deals. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. Flip to the pitcher is in time. And that's out number one on a tough play.
This is what it's all about on that right side of the diamond when you've got the first baseman involved and the pitcher as well. First baseman does a great job, knocks the ball down, gets away from a little bit, doesn't panic. The pitcher's exactly where he's supposed to be. Nice feed and a nice play for the out.
Here's Matt Olson. The 2-1. And a foul ball. One down, base is empty. And that's the strikeout looking. Fastball at the letters, frozen for strike three.
Frustrating end to the at bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Two down, nobody on. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And there's a base hit to left. And that extends the inning.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. I know that was a ground ball, but it was absolutely hammered through the infield. That's not one you're excited to get in front of if you're an infielder. You know they used to say, charge it. Crazy.
At the plate, Adam Duvall. Swinging him in. And that's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
The frame. Braves strand one, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Joe Jimenez.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Leading off.
Well, one run game. Now the third baseman, Kevin Newman. And a 1-1. Line drive, caught.
Nothing you can do about those as a hitter. Even though you know that, they still drive you absolutely crazy.
Here's the catcher, Jose Herrera.
Well, both sides equally as strong, so not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
Foul back our way, and that's out of play. And the righty deals. Just misses there. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Raisel Iglesias, the closer, is getting ready and perhaps looking at a long save opportunity here. Johnson getting loose as well. Righty to the plate. Swing and a pop off in foul ground near the fence. Two down.
Hey, man, four pitches, two outs. That is an excellent pace.
Now, the center fielder,
Jake McCarthy stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Two outs. Hot shot to first base, and he snags it to end the inning. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. They're down 3-2. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, number 49.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Well, one run game. Now in for the Braves, Sean Murphy. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. He sends it out of here, and they tack one on the board. It's 4-2.
Velocity up and in is just such a difficult location for the hitter, but this time he pulls the hands tight to the body, gets through this pitch. What conviction in that swing. Awesome job at the plate.
And next for Atlanta, Orlando Arcia. Swing and a miss, chased it out of the zone. Pitch. Wouldn't chase that time. Action in the pen down there. Bryce Jarvis, the rookie right-hander, is getting loose. Mantiply, a left-hander, also throwing. Nobody on, nobody out with a run in here at the top of the ninth. Hits and misses. It's a strikeout.
Get him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
Laureano comes up to hit. In the air to left center. McCarthy makes the grab, and there's two down.
The center fielder, number 24. Jared.
So the lineup flips over. Jared Kelnick next up for the Braves. Next offering is in for a strike. Two down, nobody on. Battling here as he fouls it away. That's
two
down
balls,
and in.
Two strikes.
Out towards right center field. McCarthy settles under it. He makes the grab, and that's the third out. Braves get one on the big fly. It's now 4-2. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth, Raisel Iglesias.
I think closer has to be one of the toughest jobs in baseball, and we see a pretty high turnover rate because of it. Every outing seems to be high pressure, this one included. We'll see if he can wrap up the win and get himself a save.
And a 2-1 on the way.
Yeah.
So Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. And here it comes. Upstairs.
Hey, look, we'll see how it factors in. I just can't emphasize how much that insurance run in the top of the ninth means. I mean, just such a big difference mentally when you're chasing two runs instead of one.
Just a mid-90s challenge fastball right there. Not much to it. And I'm sure he'd love another swing at it because it was in a very hittable location. Those are the swings where you can sometimes start to question yourself as a hitter and say, how'd I miss that? But you know, it happens.
He's two outs away. Ketel Marte up to the plate. Base is empty, one away here in the last half of inning number nine. One down, base is empty. Up the middle. On the run, sends it over to first. Not in time, he legs it out.
A nice job getting there. Good throw, but very difficult to get anybody on that one as far as you had to go and throw. You know?
Yeah, no question.
So, man aboard, and now Christian Walker. Tying run at the plate. And a count one and two. First and second with only one away.
Love how he let that ball travel. Trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Here the bottom of the ninth, one out. Lourdes Gurriel Jr. stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. And there's two away.
The batter number nine.
Pierce Johnson will come in.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate is very high, and it just breaks a ton.
So it's their last chance in this one. Blaze Alexander will hit next. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure.
On the corner for a strike, and a count one and two. With the winning run at the plate, we're in the last half of the ninth inning. This one kicks away a little as he can't squeeze it. The tag, and that's the ball game.
Full pitch save. He was just starting to get comfortable out there after throwing a lot of pitches in the bullpen in this one. But a nice job of attacking the hitters, being very efficient. And this is what you want to do. You want to come in and you want to close things out as quickly as possible.
And your final 4-2 for Chris Singleton and our entire crew. I'm John Schiavi saying so long.
the final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Atlanta Braves, 4 runs on 9 hits, no errors. They left 7 runners on base.